Here we have a newly created earthquake animation based on subject matter expert input. When setting the shape keys up in Blender, I referred in part to this graphic presented by Dr. Thomas Heaton from the California Institute of Technology in his talk, The Physics of Tall Building Collapse, available on YouTube, link in the description below. We have one tower on the left that will have damping applied, and one on the right that does not. So we needed two separate controls for when the building is properly dampened versus when it's at risk of collapse. The first step to triggering these animations via a button is to add a blank animation that we can record to. So I create one in the project window and name it something obvious like quake. Then I need a controller for my animator component, so I go ahead and create that in my project as well. With that selected in the animator window, I drag and drop my quake animation. I'll go back to that in a moment. First, I have to select my tower and drag that animator controller into the animator component of my mesh. Now with that animation on the tower, I can click record and start setting some keyframes. I'll just set them on 0 to start with, and then space them out a bit. I'm not showing the full extent of how these animations will play, just the concept of how you trigger one with a button, but I'm going to show you how to loop it. Set the last keyframe to match the first. Stop recording. Now when you press play, it sort of loops. You'll still need to go into the inspector window and select loop time on the animation itself for it to loop in play mode. That's almost done. But we can also make it loop smoother. I reset the animation to the start and select all of the keys. Then I had to do a little testing to remember the correct setting, but what I want is the auto option enabled. That smooths out the curve ends so that it bounces back and forth without the hiccup. You can adjust that further, but what I want to show next is how to wire this up to a button. So we go into the animator window again and add a new parameter. Choose the trigger option. And then I'm going to name it Quake as well. The default entry transition isn't available to be selected, so what I did first is right-click the entry and choose Make Transition. That makes a new arrow between the two that I can select, and then I can set my new Quake parameter trigger as the condition for the transition. Then I went into my canvas where I've already set up a default button. The button component has an onClick event field, so you just drag your animated object into the slot on the onClick event. Choose the function, for this it's the animator, and set trigger type string. Then in the string field, you write the name that you gave the parameter that you want triggered when you click the button. When I push play here, I realize that this isn't quite right. I need the animation not to run automatically in play mode. So what I need to do is create an empty state where the animation isn't playing, and then set the entry transition to that empty. I got confused by the wires crossing, so I just deleted the animation for a second. Made sure that the entry is into the empty state. And then I drag and drop the quake animation back in. And that's where I'll set my parameter as the condition for the transition. Everything looks right, so I test it out. But something's still wrong. Turns out at some point I had accidentally disabled the event system for the canvas in the inspector window, so when I turn it back on, everything's working as expected.